Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are doing well. So today we are back again with the part 5 of chapter 5. So what did we see in our previous sessions? We have discussed the very important structure of the central nervous system. So we have seen that the nervous system in our body is divided mainly into two different types, that is the central nervous system or the CNS and the peripheral nervous system, that is the PNS. So we have seen the first important part of central nervous system, that is the brain, and one more part of the central nervous system is nothing but the spinal cord. Alright, so the CNS consists of the brain and the spinal cord, whereas the PNS is a different part or different types of nerves originate in the peripheral nervous system, which we'll be discussing today. So the topic for today would be the spinal cord. We have already discussed the first part, that is the brain. We have seen the structure of brain, what are the parts of the brain and the major functions. Today we'll be moving with the second part of the CNS, that is spinal cord. So you guys know that your spinal cord is present behind your body. So your spinal cord starts from your hind brain. So this is your part of your hind brain. This is forebrain, this is midbrain, and this is the hind brain. So the spinal cord starts exactly from which part of the brain? It starts from your hind brain. So if you can see, your hind brain originates and gives rise to a tuft of nerve fibers or neurons or nerve cells, which are together put up and they make a tough tissue or a tough long structure called as the spinal cord. So from where is your spinal cord originating? It is originating from the hind brain and it is continuing till your lumbar region. So when you can see, if you can touch, you can touch the spinal cord dots behind your back. Yes or no? You can see that the spinal cord has been covered with a skeletal structure called as the vertebral column. So what is the origination, or from where does the spinal cord originate? It originates from the hind brain and it extends up to the lumbar region. Lumbar region is nothing but when you just move down till your hip region, is nothing but your lumbar region, this region. So it is starting from the medulla oblongata, that is which is present in your hind brain, and it is extending up to your lumbar regions. And it is a tuft of nerve fibers and it is covered by a skeletal system called as the vertebral column. So you can see the vertebral column, which is protected and which is protecting the spinal cord, which is present inside. So what exactly is the function of spinal cord? So in the earlier 18th and 19th centuries, we have seen, or the scientists have found out, that it was only the brain which was responsible. They were thinking that the brain only was responsible for the process of coordination in our body. Okay, they have seen that there was no function of spinal cord, or they exactly did not know what is the function of spinal cord. But later, the two major scientists, Leonardo da Vinci and Stephen Hales. So these two scientists were very important in recognizing that there is some functioning of spinal cord. So as I have told you, in the earlier centuries, the Greeks have just thought in the 18th and 19th century that only the brain was the main region which could coordinate all the activities of our body, and if brain is not present, the human might not be present. But these two scientists have done experiments on frog, and they have seen that whenever there was brain removed from frog, so they have taken a frog, they have conducted an experiment, and they have seen that if the brain of the frog was removed, the whole body was still functional. Okay, so the statement proved by the earlier scientists were wrong, because they have thought that it is only the brain which is responsible for coordinating the body movements. But in frog, they have found that these two scientists, whenever the brain was removed, still the body functioning and the muscular movements were seen. Okay, then they finally took into account, they took into close look at the spinal cord which originated from the brain, and they have found out that the spinal cord is responsible for controlling the muscular or any other movements in our body. Okay, they tried to pierce a pin onto the, what is it, they have tried to pierce a pin onto the spinal cord of the frog, and they have seen that as soon as the piercing took place, the frog was dead. So from this experiment, what did these both scientists conclude? They concluded that it is not only the brain which is responsible for coordinating and controlling our body movements or maintaining coordination in our body, but the spinal cord plays a very, very important role. It is not just a tuft of fibers which carry the impulses, but also it helps in controlling and coordinating each and every movement of our body. So these two scientists were very, very helpful in telling that the brain along with the spinal cord together should coordinate for any response or any reaction to be given to a particular stimulus. So from this experiment, it is very clear that it is not only the brain, but it is the spinal cord which controls and coordinates the body actions. It is not only helping in transferring of stimulus from one part of the body or giving responses or reactions to the external environment, but also it is helping in coordinating things. Okay, and if the spinal cord of any living human being or an animal is removed, the whole body will become non-functional because the impulses cannot travel, because there will be many other nerves originating from the spinal cord through which the stimulus will travel through various parts of the body. Alright, so this experiment led to the very important conclusion that the brain and the spinal cord together help in controlling and coordinating things. Now let us move on to the next thing or the next part of the nervous system, that is the peripheral nervous system. So we have seen what comes under the central nervous system. We have discussed about the brain and the spinal cord. Okay, so the brain along with the spinal cord will constitute the central nervous system. So we have seen they help in controlling and coordinating, and we have seen the various important functions of each part of the brain. How is your cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata? How are they working together in helping your body to process, and how are signals being carried? If the spinal cord is not present, what will happen? Whatever are the signals to be carried from the lower parts of your body, suppose they cannot travel through your brain and your brain cannot send a response back. So the spinal cord is a very, very important structure which runs along your back till the lumbar region of your body. It starts from the hind brain and it runs till your lumbar region, and it is protected by a vertebral column. It is cylindrical in structure. So from the spinal cord, we see that there will be various nerves originating. Okay, so your spinal cord, if you see, if this is your spinal cord, you see that there will be several nerves which will attach to your dorsal side and which will attach to your ventral side of your body. Okay, so dorsal and ventral sides, you need to remember what do you mean by dorsal side and ventral side of your body. So many nerves originate from the spinal cord, okay, which are attached to your body on the dorsal side and ventral side. So if you can see, now we are discussing about the peripheral nervous system. Alright, so the peripheral nervous system is the second type of nervous system in our body, which contains two different types of roots or connections from the spinal cord. Okay, so one connection is the dorsal root connections. So the peripheral nervous system has two connections in your body. The first one is the dorsal root connections and second one is the ventral root connections. So if you can see the dorsal root and ventral root, and this is the TS of spinal cord. TS of spinal cord. So the peripheral nervous system in our body has the two important connections called the dorsal roots and the ventral roots. So there were again two important scientists who experimented on the roots. Okay, they have seen what are these roots. Are these roots functional in this spinal cord? Are they carrying any responses or are they carrying any stimuluses? So the two important scientists were Charles Bell Scotland and Francis McGandy. So these two scientists were very, very important in finding out what was the function of these dorsal roots and ventral roots or the connections in the spinal cord. Okay, which originated from the spinal cord, and we talk about it under the peripheral nervous system. Okay, so all the regions of the central nervous system, that is the center of your body, your brain and the spinal cord, we have clubbed it under one system called as the central nervous system. Peripheral nervous system means which are away from your center. For example, if this is your spinal cord and your brain, the peripheral nervous system constitutes all the nerves which are present away from your central nervous system. Okay, so as I have told you, each and every part of your body is made up of nerves. Okay, so each nerve, okay, which is originating from your spinal cord can be considered as the peripheral nervous system. So just remember, the peripheral nervous system contains nerves other than the central nervous system. Okay, brain and the spinal cord constitute the central nervous system, but the peripheral nervous system are the nerves which you see on the periphery of your body, which originate or continue to all parts of your body. Okay, and in the peripheral nervous system, you see that the spinal cord, in the spinal cord, you see that the gray matter is present. Okay, so in the brain, we have seen that there is gray matter and white matter. Alright, then in this you see that the white matter is present towards the outer side of the spinal cord, whereas the gray matter is present in between the spinal cord. Okay, so we have seen in the brain that the gray matter is present towards the outer side. So if this is your brain, you have seen that the gray matter is present towards the periphery and the white matter is constituting the middle part of the brain. But in case of spinal cord, we find that the middle part will constitute the white matter, whereas the outer regions of the spinal cord or the peripheral regions of the spinal cord will have the gray matter. So in between, you see that the white matter is constituting, whereas the outside to the periphery, you see that there is gray matter. So we have seen that in the brain, there are two important matters, the gray matter and the white matter. The gray matter, as I have told you, it is present towards the periphery, whereas the white matter in brain will constitute the between part. And you see the reverse in case of spinal cord. So when you take a section of spinal cord, you see that the white matter is present towards the periphery of the spinal cord, whereas the gray matter is present constituting in between the spinal cord. Are you clear? So spinal cord, we have discussed, plays a very important role in continuing the coordination things in our body. So these two scientists were very, very important to find out what was the exact functioning of this dorsal root or the ventral root. Okay, so the peripheral nervous system has a very, very important role in transferring the stimuluses from your sensory nerves or the motor nerves. So let us see how. So these two roots showed different functions. So as I have told you, the spinal cord, when the section was taken, okay, from the spinal cord, as I have told you, there will be various nerves arising, and these nerves which are arising from the spinal cord to all parts of the body, they show connections, and we call that system as the peripheral nervous system. So obviously it will be made up of nerves. Okay, when these two were experimenting, okay, on the two kinds of connections from the spinal cord, that is the dorsal root connection and the ventral root connections, okay, they found that these two roots have two different functions. And when they have seen that the dorsal root was cut, or when the dorsal root connection was cut to the spinal cord, they saw that this did not show any reaction. Okay, all the body movements were continuing. So whenever this dorsal root connection was removed from the spinal cord, they did not find any major difference on the functioning of the body. But when this ventral root connection okay, you can see this ventral root connection. But when this ventral root connection was removed from the spinal cord, they saw that most of the muscular movements were nearly stopped. Okay, so these two important dorsal root connections and ventral root connections had two different functions. Whenever the dorsal root was cut or when it was removed, it did not show major difference in the body coordinating things. Okay, but when they have seen the ventral root connection was removed, they saw that the ventral root, okay, was showing a very important response. That is, whenever the ventral root was cut, they saw that the body of the organism immediately stopped showing any response or reaction. So from this they concluded that these both have two different functions, and the function of dorsal root is to carry sensation from the sense organs to the brain, that is sensing things. So dorsal root, sensory nerves, and ventral root, the motor nerves. So whenever I tell the motor nerves, they carry impulses from your brain to your all parts of your body. So what will happen when this ventral root connection is cut? They have seen that from the brain the messages come, they travel through the spinal cord, and when the connection is cut here, what will happen? We cannot show any response because the motor nerve which is carrying the impulses, this connection is cut, so we do not show any response. Whereas when they have cut this dorsal root is sensory neuron or nerve which carries stimulus from the sense organs to the brain. But this do not show major difference because once the stimulus is carried, then only the brain can progress and finally process, and the information can travel through the ventral root. So they found that these two roots, the dorsal root and ventral root of the peripheral nervous system, played a very very important role, and they had two major functions: the dorsal root for sensation and the ventral root, which played a very important role in carrying impulses from the brain to your sense organs and to show a response or stimulus. So this showed that whenever this ventral root ganglion or ventral root of the spinal cord is being cut, the motor new impulses, the motor nerves which carry the impulses to show a response, was rendered. Are you clear? So these two scientists finally came to a conclusion that there should be a clear peripheral nervous system which can carry messages to all parts of our body. Okay, so the peripheral nervous system is made up of two different kinds of nerves. First one is the cranial nerves. First part is the cranial nerves, and the second part is the spinal nerves. So the peripheral nervous system consists of two pairs of nerves coming, two different kinds of nerves arising. Those are the cranial nerves and the spinal nerves. So what do you understand by the word cranial? It is nothing but it is relating to the word cranium. Yes or no? So where did you come across this word cranium? We have seen that cranium is the outermost covering of the brain. So whatever are the nerves which are arising from the brain are called as cranial nerves. So what do you mean by cranial nerves? All the nerves arising from the brain are called as the cranial nerves. And what do you mean by spinal nerves? All the nerves which are arising from the spinal cord throughout are called as spinal nerves. So cranial nerves arising from your brain and the spinal nerves arising from your spinal cord together make up the peripheral nervous system. Are you clear, students? So peripheral nervous system is a very vast nervous system containing huge number of nerves arising from your brain, called as the cranial nerves, and arising of nerves from the spinal cord in very large amounts, called as the spinal nerves. Are you clear till here? So children, in the picture you can see the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. So as I have told you, the peripheral nervous system contains the two different types of nerves arising from the brain and the spinal cord. You can see the yellow color nerves which are arising from the spinal cord and they are extending to your legs and hands. They constitute the peripheral nervous system. So all the nerves connecting from your brain and your spinal cord to all parts of your body make up the peripheral nervous system. Are you clear? So children, we have seen a picture where you have seen how the peripheral nervous system nerves are connecting from your spinal cord to all parts of your body. So please do not get confused between central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. The nerves present in your body other than your brain and your spinal cord are called as the peripheral nerves. Okay, they arise from your brain and spinal cord and connect to all parts of the body. So we have seen that the peripheral nervous system has the cranial nerves which arise from the cranium, that is your brain, and the spinal nerves which arise from your spinal cord. So there are 12 pairs of cranial nerves, that is from the brain you see that there will be 12 pairs of nerves arising which connect with your all parts of the body and spinal cord, and the spinal nerves are 31 pairs of spinal nerves. So how many pairs of cranial nerves are arising from your brain? 12 pairs. And how many pairs of spinal nerves are arising from your spinal cord and connecting to all the other parts of your body? 31 pairs of spinal nerves. So you can see that the 12 pairs will arise from the brain, they connect to various parts, or they may also connect to your spinal cord and then they can connect to all parts of the body. And from the spinal cord you see that there will be 31 pairs arising from each part of the spinal cord, that is if this is a long spinal cord. Okay, so this is a long spinal cord which we have discussed. You see that there will be nearly 31 pairs of spinal nerves extending from whole of your spinal cord. So it can be whole from the top to bottom. And here you see that there is brain. From brain you see that there will be 12 pairs of nerves arising. Are you clear? So this is how the peripheral nervous system is. Okay, so please do not get confused between central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. So in our today's class, what did we discuss, students? We have seen the second important part of central nervous system, that is spinal cord. We have seen that spinal cord is a long tuft of nerve fibers arising from the hind brain or the medulla oblongata, and it extends till the lumbar region. Lumbar region is nothing but your back. Till your hip region is your lumbar region. It is very cylindrical and it is protected by a skeletal framework called as the vertebral column. Okay, and the spinal cord TS, when we take, we see that the spinal cord has the gray matter in between and white matter outside, and it helps in sending of impulses, and not only of communicating impulses throughout your body but also controlling and coordinating the activities of your body. Then we have started with the next nervous system, that is the peripheral nervous system, which means the nerves arising from your body other than your brain and your spinal cord. So the peripheral nervous system has two important major functions, that is carrying of sensory impulses and motor impulses from your brain to your sense organs. So what is the function of the peripheral nervous system? It is nothing but the sensory nerves and the motor nerves which are working together in carrying impulses from your sense organs to your brain, again from your brain to all parts of your body for giving a response. So we have seen that the peripheral nervous system is made up of two different types of nerves originating from the brain and the spinal cord. So the cranial nerves are the first type of nerves in the peripheral nervous system, which are 12 pairs, and they originate from the brain, and the spinal nerves are 31 pairs of spinal nerves which originate from the spinal cord. So this is all about the central nervous system and the spinal cord and the peripheral nervous system. So in our next classes, we'll be moving forward with the autonomous nervous system, and let us know more about it in our next classes. Until then, students, please do not forget to read the textbook, as this is a very, very important topic. Underline the scientists' names. Read each and every line as we have discussed clearly in today's class. Once you go through your textbook, all of your points which we have discussed today will be very crystal clear. Are you clear till here, students? So in our next classes, we'll be moving forward. Until then, revise the textbooks, and thank you.